You are King, our Heavenly Father, our teacher, our friend. You are our helper, our all in all. Everything that we need you to be, you are to us. Our great I Am, our help, our friend. For that, our hearts are open to receive from you today. We thank you for opening the heavens unto us. Thank you for opening your heart unto us to receive us as your precious and prized possession. Thank you for the redemption that has brought us out from the miry clay, broken the chains from our hearts and our minds and our lives, and has redeemed us permanently from the places of slavery. You have translated us from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of your dear Son, even before we recognized you. We thank you for while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Thank you for your condemnation, for the condemnation that has been removed from us, and you have given unto us redemption, love, forgiveness. Thank you, Lord. Even as we fellowship with you today, we thank you for the opportunity to pray. We thank you for the opportunity to study. We thank you for the opportunity to commune with you without any fear, knowing that the blood speaks better things than the blood of Abel. For that we thank you. Thank you for your blood that is speaking over our hearts. Thank you for your blood that is speaking over our minds. Thank you for your blood that is speaking over our lives. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Good morning. Welcome to Prayer Banquet. As we spend time to fellowship with the Lord today and pray the truth of God's word, the scripture makes us understand we shall know the truth, or we shall come into the experience of the truth, and then we can walk in the freedom that has already been purchased for us by the blood of Christ. That is, the truth makes us free, but the truth you don't know will not experience the freedom it has. There is so much power in the truth of God to make any human person walk in the liberty of the truth. Jesus said, I am the truth. So we are walking in the truth of a person. We are walking in the reality of God, the reality of Christ. And that is the truth we are bringing into our consciousness, bringing into our awareness, so that we can walk in the liberty by which Christ has set us free. So one of the things we do today is to speak the truth of God's word over our minds, over our lives, and bring ourselves to embracing that reality. Whatever is real before God can be real to you. As He is, so are we in this world. But not every one of us have experienced what He is experiencing. So the only way to experience what He is experiencing is to come into the awareness of what He has come into the awareness. And so one of that is to open our eyes. The Bible says as we renew our mind, we are transformed. To transform means to change from one state to another. And so that is why we are praying. We are praying the truth so that we can enter into the transformation that He is experiencing on our behalf, and that we can experience that is already portioned for us. Ephesians chapter 3, we're taking our prayer declaration today from there. Ephesians chapter 3, and I'll read it from verse 14. The Passion Translation. We're going to take verse by verse this week, and we're going to begin to speak the truth of God's word. It says, so I kneel humbly. Paul is saying, I kneel. I come before. To kneel means to come and to acknowledge the existence of something or someone superior, of the Lord. When they say someone is Lord, it means that there is nothing that he doesn't have control over. It is nothing that doesn't have right over. So I kneel humbly in awe before the Father of our Lord, Jesus the Messiah, the perfect Father of every father and child in heaven and on earth. So the first recognition is that when we pray, we are praying before a perfect one, before the Father of every child in heaven and on earth. You are not coming before just man. You're not just praying because you just want to pray. You're not just praying because it's a religious thing to do. No, Paul is saying, when I kneel, I know who I'm kneeling before. When I speak, I know I'm speaking before. When I ask, I know I'm asking before. When I declare, I know I'm declaring before. The Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, because Jesus here represents not just our Savior, but our elder brother. So the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, that means you are standing before your Father. You are standing before your Heavenly Father, not just an earthly Father, a perfect one, the one there is no imperfection. Father, we thank you because there is no imperfection in you. Father, we thank you because there is no failure in you. We recognize that your lordship is superior to every lordship, every political system, every religious system, every material system, every emotional system, every financial system, every health system, every educational system, Lord, every legal system, that your lordship supersedes the lordship that is operational upon the earth. Before the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ in heaven and on earth. That means we are standing before the judge of all judges, the King of all kings. We recognize you as the master of everything. Lord, even the master of our lives, the master of our future, the master of our unknown tomorrows, the master of our past, the master of our mistakes, the master of all the accusation of the enemy that the enemy has risen and spoken against us and lifted up against us in condemnation. You are the master of every event. You are the master of our jobs, our bosses, our office. You are the master of everything that we cannot see and the thing that we can see. You are the master of every event. You are the master of every concern. You are the master of every worry, every issue, every idea, every future goal and future dream. You are the master of every anticipation, every expectation. You are our master. Lord, and not just that you are our master, you are our Father. And you are a perfect Father that we can relate with. So we thank you. What an opportunity to know that we can relate with you, knowing that our future is secured. Because our future you have control over. Our tomorrow you have dominion over. Our expectation you have control over. Thank you, Father. We come humbly recognizing you as Lord, as the I Am. Not the I was, the I am, the present continuous being that is always Lord. You are the one who sits over the circle of the earth. The inhabitants before you are like grasshoppers. We recognize your lordship today. So we thank you. We are coming to thank you. Today we just want to recognize your awesomeness. We want to recognize your mightiness. We want to recognize that you are King, you are Master, you are Lord over everything that we can ever imagine. Now we know that our future is not in the hands of a man, an event, a situation, a political system, or a country. No, our futures are not in the hands of our education or our failures, our mistakes, or our past. No, our future is secured in you, for we know that you are Master, you are Father, and you are perfect. Scripture says every good and perfect gift comes from the Father of lights, who there is no variable and no shadow of turning. Lord, because you are our Father, you are always on our side. Because you are our Father, you are always working on our behalf. Because you are our Father, you are always on our defense. He said, if God be for us, who can be successfully against us? So we thank you. Nothing can successfully knock us down. Nothing can successfully pull us down. Our futures are not successfully rubbed off. No, nothing can successfully take away everything that you promised us. For in Christ Jesus, everything that pertains to life and godliness have been released to us. For this we thank you. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. That's how we start our prayer, in recognition. We just keep reminding ourselves the truth that our Father is a perfect Father and is working on our behalf. Paul says, I come before, I kneel before the perfect Father of every father and child in heaven and on earth. And when I pray that he would unveil within you the unlimited riches of his glory and favor. So let's stop there today. We want to pray, Lord, because you are our Father, unveil to me the unlimited riches of your glory within and favor within me. Show me the favor that I'm not aware of. Show me the glory that is within me that I'm not conscious of. Unveil to my heart the unlimited, not the limited portion of glory that comes because of one effort or the connections I have or the relationships I've developed. Not the glory that comes from my family name or from my educational background, or my savings, or my account, or my finances, or my job, or my salary. No, the glory that comes from within me, that you have put within me from the foundation of the earth. He said, you created me in your image and likeness. He said, man has fallen short of the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. But through Christ Jesus, that glory has been restored. Open unto my heart. Open unto my mind the glory and the favor of God that is within me. Open to my mind. Let my heart be unveiled. Let my heart see the glory within me. The glory, the weight of your presence. The weight of your favor. The weight of your honor. The weight of your goodness. Lord, unveil to me as I begin this wonderful Tuesday. Unveil to my heart the glory within me. The beauty within me, the favor that you have granted to me, the things that are all are possible because I am a believer. So that all things are possible to him that believes. I have come into the possibility realm and I am not even aware of it. Lord, unveil to my heart. Let the scales fall off. Let the veils be torn. Let the dross be removed from my eyes in an of understanding. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. I declare today that my eyes of understanding are open, that my heart is unveiled, that I begin to behold the wondrous, glorious, wonders, unglorious, unlimited riches, unlimited glory, unlimited favor that is within me. That is within me as a person created in the image and likeness of Christ. When Christ died and said, it is finished, he has opened unto me the ability to become a new creation, the glory of God in the person of human flesh, the glory of God packaged in a human person. Lord, I thank you. Open my eyes. I declare this day, this wonderful, wonderful, beautiful day, that my eyes are open to see, my ears are open to hear, my heart is open to unveil. That which my heart has not seen or experienced before now. By your Spirit, the unveiling of the glory within, the unveiling of the favor within, that I will walk in reality of who I am and who I'm born to be. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. This is my declaration today. My eyes are open to see. My eyes are open to be on to experience the glory and the favor of God within me in Christ Jesus. The unlimited glory, the unlimited favor in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Begin your day just declaring this truth. Begin your day just speaking this truth over your heart, over your mind, over your family, over your sons, over your daughters, over your experience, over your future, over your tomorrow. Just speak it, speak it, speak it, speak it. Because the truth is that whatever you speak, Scripture says that you shall have what you say. So say the truth and walk in the liberty of the sons of God. Amen. Until I come away tomorrow, just keep speaking the truth and experience the transformation of God's power. Amen. God bless you. This is Prayer Banquet, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bless you.